For the latest updates on the Indian startup ecosystem, subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon.
Hello and welcome to yourstory.com. I'm Debolina.
I'm Sutrishna, and here's a quick look at the top stories we covered this week.
Mr. Ratan Tata, the name needs no introduction. An industrialist, investor, and philanthropist, Mr. Tata comes off as an immensely humble and compassionate person, and rightly so. Your Story's founder and CEO Shraddha Sharma recently had the opportunity to interview Mr. Tata for the second time, and this time inside his house and in his private space. In a deeply personal, honest, and candid interview, Mr. Tata reveals what defines him as a person, his dreams of an equal opportunity India, and his advice to youngsters who look up to him. Exclusively at Your Story, we take you inside the home and heart of Ratan Tata, the man behind one of India's oldest business empires.
Whether you're a fan of fantasy cricket or it's winner-winner chicken dinner all the way for you, 2019 has been a good year for gaming. After all, this was the year when gaming went mainstream, setting the stage for 2020, which is poised to be a key year for India's gaming industry. For starters, in the new year, a few more gaming unicorns might be born. Then new, immersive gaming experiences will be created. More localized games will also be launched, and fantasy sports will go beyond cricket. But the most important of all, the year 2020 will witness the emergence of a gaming ecosystem in the country. Find out more about all the emerging gaming trends in our 2020 outlook only on Your Story.
29-year-old Nikhil Kumar was born in Kolar to a multi-generational engineer family. So it wasn't a surprise when he went down the same path himself despite his parents being bankers. Having started a club for computer programming, Nikhil built a voter application system in school itself. He worked with Tally and financial software company Intuit before joining the India stack. Our techie this week is the secret warrior who helped make UPI a reality. We trace Nikhil's path from a small town to working on developing APIs.
With fashion and apparel consumption on an all-time rise, manufacturers often deal with situations where they run out of stock. Bengaluru-based startup Incref has been helping these clothing companies by providing intelligence technology that understands consumer behavior and maps it to the supply chain. No wonder then that Incref's technology has found a ready-made market within a short span. Founded by IIT alumni Rajul Jain, Anshuman Agarwal and Romil Jain, it has grown from $150,000 in sales to over $2 million in sales over a period of 2 years. It has even witnessed a 10x growth since inception. Today, Incref counts more than 17 brands among its clients, including biggies like Reliance Ajio, Wrong, Mango and Puma.
CA Harshavardhan Lunia had it all. A cushy job at ICICI's corporate office in London, the financial capital of the world. Yet, he surprised everyone, including his own family, when he returned to Ahmedabad. Why? Well, the year was 2014 and the startup and MSME ecosystem was booming in India. Along with friend Mukul Sachin, Harshavardhan launched fintech startup Lendingkart. The idea was simple. Young India was getting into business and were in need of capital. Lendingkart thus targeted entrepreneurs between ages 35 and 45 and provided them with short-term working capital loans for their businesses. Having disbursed more than 70,000 loans across 55,000 MSMEs, Lendingkart has raised a total of $143 million so far.
The Indian startup ecosystem is dominated by the likes of Flipkart, Paytm, Swiggy and Zomato. But there are also many deep tech startups that solve core software engineering challenges. Among these is Harness, a Silicon Valley headquartered technology company that has its research and development center in Bengaluru. Co-founded by Jyoti Bansal, who shot to fame when AppDynamics got acquired by Cisco for $3.7 billion, Harness basically aims to simplify the entire software delivery process. and it is achieving this feat by bringing the industry's first continuous delivery as a service platform to market.
Those were the top stories from this week, and this fabulous outfit was sponsored by Fable Street.
Do check out their collection on their official website, and for more such news and updates from the Indian startup ecosystem, like, share and subscribe.